Now, Mr. McIntyre, I'm impressed with you because in all honesty, if it wasn't for you coming in there at the end, me and Roman would have likely not be standing here as tag team champions.
Yeah, Donald, I just want to do what's right. With CM Punk being the bitch that he is, I just wanted to take my mind off things and help the greatest president of all time retain his title. We're going to defeat those Democrats together and we'll save this country.
Actually, it's going to be me that saves this country and not you, but nevertheless, I believe you've done enough to earn yourself a role in the Big D World Order. And taking inspiration from the bloodline, you'll now be known as the Honorary D, Drew McIntyre.
Are we sure we should do this?
Yeah, he doesn't like me or Roman all that much, and we don't really like him either, if I'm being completely honest.
Talk your shit, Daddy Dom. I feel the exact same way.
Well, you four will have to find a way to work together if you want to keep this thing going. Look, all of us together, we hold three of the five titles currently in this series. I hold the now being called Billionaire title. Me and Roman both hold the McDonald's Tag Team titles. And you, Liv, you hold the Women's Championship. We can't let this go, no matter what.
He's right. We should let our differences aside and focus on the future and not the past. So, are we good?
Fine. We're good, Drew.
That's what I like to hear, Roman.
Wait, guys, it's Undertaker.
You've got to be kidding me, not this guy again.
Oh, look who it is. It's the Big D World Order, and the fat ass himself, Ronald McDonald J. Trump. See what I did there? Because you remind me of Ronald McDonald.
Yeah, I get it, dumbass. Listen here, I know what you've been doing to Joe Biden. And yeah, while I may not like the guy all that much, it's disgusting what you've been doing to him. You're manipulating an 81, almost 82-year-old man. This is practically elder abuse.
I honestly don't know what you're talking about. What Joe has been doing recently, like with the Soul Siphon payback, I was just as surprised and shocked as all of you were. I don't know what's going on with him or the voices he was talking about last episode. I've been hearing them myself, actually.
These voices you're talking about, they're just lies straight from your ass. This is all you're doing to try and use Biden to get championships and shit, and we won't let you get away with it. Right, guys? Guys.
I recommend you stay out of my business with Joe Biden, or things are going to get pretty rough for you.
What did you do to my friends? Bring them back!
Have you ever thought that I said the same?
You're a monster! Huh? Where did he go?
Hey, Trump, you good, man?
I'm catching this in 4K Ultra HD right here, fam.
Did you guys see all of that? Did you see The Undertaker, too?
We watched you put on the show of a lifetime by talking to yourself about Joe Biden and shit. That's what we saw.
Yeah, we didn't see The Undertaker. You were just there talking to yourself while staring off into the distance.
Whoa, well,
Is everything all right?
Don't worry, Liv. Everything is fine. Don't worry about me.
Well, how about now that I'm the honorary D of the group? Let's hit some clubs.
Same here. I need some ass in my face right about now. I'm stressed.
I'm not talking about the strip club, idiot. We're not about to see Kamala Harris perform.
What a way to disappoint your tribal chief.
I'll meet you guys there, all right?
Say less, young blood. Let's go, guys.
I have to find Biden. But I think the best way to talk to him is not through 2K24, but rather make a trip to the White House and talk to him there.
Hey guys, Barry Obama is back because I have an important announcement for episode 13. And that announcement is me officially announcing that I will be holding an open challenge for my undisputed championship. And the first person to come out from that Walmart will be my opponent. Bring it on.
It's my time to show the world that I still got it. Out to teach Dominic that his daddy can still hang in the big leagues. Oh, hey, Randy, how's it going?
Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out!
Yes, amigo. Looks like you won't be heading to accept that open challenge. More like Casa de la KO. Next time, leave the luchador stuff at Taco Tuesday and let the Viper handle the big leagues. Viva la RKO, you dumb bitch.
Randy, what the hell? I thought we were cool, bro. And come on, you didn't have to disrespect homie Ray like that. But I mean, an open challenge is an open challenge. And I haven't defended this title as much as I should have this series. So I see your motivation.
The voices are calling for me, Barack. And they are calling me to you. However, I do have a lot of respect for you. I really do, unlike Cody Rhodes. But don't think I'm going to try every trick I've learned over the past 30 years to take that title off of your shoulder and onto mine where it belongs. I'll see you next episode, Barack.
See you then, Randy. May the best man win. Can we stop staring at each other, please? Thanks.
All right, boys, so I brought you two here today to discuss what happened at the end of episode 12, where you two lost to the Big D Chiefs and subsequently quit altogether and vowed to never return to the series. And I hope today to change that and get you guys back.
Sorry, Brandon, but we're not going back to that shit.
Yeah.
All the Big D World Order does is cheat, cheat, cheat.
Yeah.
Just like Donald claimed the 2020 election was cheated from him, and we're honestly sick of it.
Yeah.
Look, Cody, I feel you. I really do. But you can build back up from this. You can't quit. We need you out there, fam.
What's the point anymore, Brandon?
Yeah.
They're just going to keep on doing this.
Yeah.
And now they have Drew motherfucking McIntyre.
Yeah.
Like, come on, man. It's not worth it.
Yeah.
Preach.
Yeah.
Okay, how about this? How about you two take a break from tag team competition and focus more on singles competition? So that's why I'm proposing the two of you to compete in two of the three Money in the Bank qualifying matches in episode 14.
I mean, I see the vision, but if we both win the qualifiers, then wouldn't we just have to face each other in the Money in the Bank match? Doesn't make much sense to me. I don't want to fight my boyfriend like that.
Bro.
Money in the Bank matches are every man for themselves, so teaming wouldn't really work.
Well, I guess this could be a good opportunity. And we can kind of move away from the tag team title stuff for now, so I accept the offer. Jay, what about you?
Cody, I'm so fucking high right now that I completely forgot what we were talking about here.
And I'll take that as a yes. And I'll get those qualifying matches set up, and I'll let you guys know your opponents next episode. And don't worry, I won't have you two face each other. I'm not Vince McMahon.
Sounds good.
What's going on again?
All right, I'm down in the White House tunnels right now. These were built back in the 1940s when World War II broke out, and these tunnels go directly to the White House basement where Joe is probably sleeping. I do have my disguise, and I'll put it on when I get there. And don't ask how I even managed to get into these tunnels. Some questions should remain unanswered. Okay, I got my Kamala mask on, so let's go up. Here it goes. Joe, what the fuck is going on?
Kamala, get away from me. Don't hurt me again.
What? Joe, is there any Secret Service down here at all?
I don't know. I forgot.
Jesus Christ, it's not Kamala. It's me, Trump.
Ah, Trump, what the hell are you doing?
Shut the fuck up, Joe. Don't worry about how I ended it up here. All I want to know is what's going on with you lately. You've been all strange and supernatural, and just by looking at you, it seems to have spread into your real-life self. You're all pale and desaturated.
Wait, what were you trying to say there? Were you trying to say desaturated, perhaps?
Don't make fun of my speech impediment, bitch.
I don't know what you're talking about. Nothing is going on with me. Just get out of here.
I just want to help you, Joe. I may not like you all that much, but what Undertaker has been doing to you has been too much for your own good.
He hasn't been doing anything to me from what I remember.
Stop thinking that way. I know all of this is his doing.
Maybe you're right.
Joe, your dinner's ready. I made it with some new ingredients, as per usual.
Donald, you have to get out of here. She's coming. Hey, Kamala.
Here's your dinner.
Wow, how nice of you. Looks delicious.
Enjoy that. And I'll see you tomorrow. Wait, were these boxes here before? It seems like they're blocking something off, Joe. Did you do this?
Well, some guys came down here to do maintenance, so maybe they moved some things. I forgot.
How would they get down here if I had the basement door locked shut?
Well, they went through the floor. Yeah, they went through the floor, and they saw me, and they thought I was Bill Clinton.
Okay, that sounds good. Well, in that case, I gotta go back to campaigning. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay. That was a close one. But why does Donald want to help me even with all of the stuff we went through with each other? It makes no sense. I know The Undertaker is not doing anything to me, but maybe he is. Maybe I'm too stupid to understand. Maybe I'll have to get the answers myself. I do have to take a shit pretty bad, so I'll do that first.